and gentlemen, good evening, and welcome to our 15th annual show. There is very little that needs to be said about Sherlock Holmes because we all believe we already know everything about him, which is of course not true.
Let me just remind you that there were no mobile phones in Sherlock Holmes' days, so please switch yours off. And then we are going to bring you a most elementary Sherlock Holmes, and we hope you will like it, and when you've liked it, give freely afterwards. Thank you.
Watson!
What is it?
I mean, what time is it?
Quarter past seven, I'm afraid.
What? The house on fire again?
No. Very sorry to knock you up, Watson, but it's the common lot this morning. Mrs. Hudson has been knocked up. She retorted on me and I on you.
What is it, then?
A client. Or rather, a schoolgirl.
What?
Yes, I appreciate your fast-taking effects. It seems a very young lady arrived in a considerable state of excitement who insists upon seeing me. Now, when young ladies wander about the metropolis at this hour of the morning and knock sleepy people up out of their beds, I presume that it is something very pressing which they have to communicate. Should it prove to be an interesting case, you would, I'm sure, wish to follow it from the outset. I thought at any rate that I should call you and give you the chance.
My dear fellow, I would not miss it for anything. Just give me a moment to dress and we can meet this very young lady in here. Have you any idea how young she is?
Mrs. Hudson said she can be hardly older than 14.
14? Well, that is very young.
As I said, I have very little experience in talking with such children.
But Wiggins?
Wiggins is a boy and a street child. He is extraordinary and clever. This here is a common schoolgirl, I believe.
Well, perhaps her story is not so common. Let's have her in.
My dear madam, my name is Sherlock Holmes. This here is my friend and associate, Dr. Watson, before whom you can speak as freely as before myself. I'm glad to see that Mrs. Hudson has had the good sense of lighting a fire. Shall I order you a cup of hot coffee, for I observe that you are shivering?
It is not cold which makes me shiver.
No, I see, but you must not fear. We shall soon set matters right, I have no doubt. You have come in by train this morning, I see.
How do you know?
I only observed the second half of return ticket in the palm of your right glove. You must have started very early, and yet you had a good drive in a dog cart along heavy roads before you reached the station.
That's true, but how?
There is no mystery, my dear madam. The left arm of your jacket is splattered with mud in no less than seven places. The marks are perfectly fresh. There is no other vehicle but a dog cart, which throws up any mud in that direction, and then only when you sit on the left-hand side of the driver.
Whatever your reasons may be, you're perfectly correct. I started from college before six, reached Cromer at 20 past, and came in by the first train. Sir, I can't stand this train no longer. I shall go mad if it continues.
From college near Cromer before six? Then it must be Charlton's Ladies College that you call your home.
That is true.
And you haven't had breakfast yet?
No, sir.
My dear Watson, will you please ring for Mrs. Hudson and ask her to send some breakfast up?
Of course.
I've heard of you, Mr. Holmes. We have a very kind and experienced new singing mistress who told us she had met you and that you could solve any unusual problem. She said you were brilliant and nearly never made a mistake.
Nearly never? Pray, tell me who this wonderfully critical person is to whom I owe your acquaintance.
Her name is Mrs. Norton. And she said you were best man at her wedding. Do you remember her?
Isn't that the marriage?
Yes, it is.
But that was in 1888.
March 1888. I shall never forget it. It is like yesterday.
that woman. I thought she had left the country for good.
So it is true. She came back half a year ago. Her husband died in an accident, and she wanted to return to the old country where she had been happy, she said.
Irene Adler.
That was the name under which she was a famous opera star. But now she's our singing mistress. And really, you couldn't wish for a more experienced one.
I bet. And she suggested asking me about your mystery.
No, sir. She told our group about you some time ago on an outing. And when these strange things occurred, I remembered what she had told us.
Yes, then I suppose you'd better begin with telling her own story. But of course, after you've had some naked biscuits.
I had already prepared something. Ye gentlemen never think of the needs of girls or women.
Come, come, my good Mrs. Hudson, we're not all that bad.
But of course you are. Mr. Holmes never cared for women.
That is not totally correct.
And I was married, happily.
You never brought her here. I never seen her. So what do I know?
She died too soon. Even my medical knowledge couldn't save her.
Anyway, this is only a girl. Be kind to her.
We intend to be.
She would make a good prefect at our school. Energetic and understanding.
Yes. Which brings us back to the problem that brought you here at this very early hour of the day. Possibly without the knowing of your prefect, which will get you and possibly us into very serious trouble, unless you have a very good reason.
The best. My friend Maggie has disappeared. Kidnapped.
Aha.
Haven't you heard of it yet? I thought you heard of these things sooner than the other people. Maggie, Lady Margaret in full, is the only daughter and heir of the Duke of Holderness. She disappeared 3 days ago.
Holderness? The former cabinet minister?
I think so, yes.
Holderness, 6th Duke of KGPC. My dear, half the alphabet of titles and honors. Baron of Beverly, Earl of Garston, my God, Lord Lieutenant of Hallamshire, Cabinet Minister until last year. First wife was Edith, the daughter of Sir Charles Appledore, now married to a considerably younger woman called Sylvia. Well, this man is certainly one of the most important subjects of the crown.
And one of the richest and most generous. He has put up a reward for the finding of his daughter. Did you not know that?
It has not been made public.
He said it on the school corridor, loudly. £5,000 for his daughter, and £1,000 for the name of the kidnappers. Before he threatened to have our headmistress fired unless Maggie reappeared quickly, Miss Riggs was very excited and pulled him into her study, saying this was nothing for other people's ears. He laughed.
Laughed?
Bitterly. He stayed into her study for another 30 minutes, and his voice very loud inside. Unfortunately, the doors are so thick you couldn't understand anything.
The police were called in.
No, nothing of this kind. The Duke's secretary and the teachers looked everywhere, but they found nothing. Or rather, something which they think explains everything.
Order and method! One step after another. When was the disappearance discovered?
Maggie was last seen on Monday evening. She sleeps next door and you must walk through my room to get into hers. It was my job, being older than she is, to look after her. She's only 12 and came to college last year. But she's nice and friendly and doing well. Everybody likes her.
Monday evening? What time about?
About 9 o'clock. The room's on the second floor. The next morning, her room was empty. Since she didn't leave through my room, she must have climbed out of the window. There's a tree growing up next to her window. A set of clothes and her shoes were missing. Nobody believes that she was taken from her room. Somehow, someone must have made her leave the room. Ever since that time, there has not been a sound or trace of her. I'm deeply worried.
Quite rightly. The police should have been called in. I should have been called earlier. 3 days is a long time. Too long to find reliable traces now. And what was the other thing that was discovered?
How do you know?
You mentioned that they have found something which they think explains everything.
Indeed, our German teacher, Dr. Wagner, has also disappeared.
Anything about him?
He has been at our school about 2 years. Good teacher, everybody says. But I don't like him. Too strict, and I don't like German anyway.
Might he have kidnapped her or convinced her to live with him?
No, I don't think so. He was not young, not handsome or attractive. He didn't teach her. They hardly knew each other. It is all very strange, but he's been gone ever since then too.
And the police haven't been told about him either?
No one. I couldn't stand it any longer. This is dreadful. Margaret may be dead by now.
Yes. This is something we must take into account.
Oh, Mr. Holmes, if you are as brilliant as Mrs. Norton says, you must come and help us. You must clear this whole thing up. You must save poor Maggie.
You like her very much?
I feel responsible.
How old are you?
14.
Too young to feel responsible. And yet you act more responsibly than your teachers in this case. And far too young to wander about the metropolis at this hour of the morning.
Someone had to do it.
Does anyone from your school know where you are?
My roommate, Lady Frances. Will you please come and help us find Maggie?
If she can be saved, I will save her. My dear Watson, will you please ring for Mrs. Hudson once more? You will wait at Mrs. Hudson's place below until we've had our breakfast and packed a few things. We will accompany you home then.
Thank you very much, Mr. Holmes. It must also be a great pleasure for you to meet Mrs. Norton again.
A pleasure. Perhaps we shall see. Mrs. Hudson, will you please take care of our guests and send us breakfast up? We will be away for a few days then.
I thought as much. Shall I order you a coach to the station?
In an hour's time, I should think.
All right. Come along, me girl.
Yes, madam.
Don't forget breakfast.
Irene?
Adler.
Norton. This whole case is strange. It seems like a trap to me.
Trap? For who? For Lady Margaret?
For us. The game's afoot, my dear Watson, and the refusal of calling the police is most extraordinary.
It's a ladies' college, Holmes.
I hope it's not one of those fighting for the right to vote and female emancipation. Crazy women they create.
I remember my wife talking about it. She always said, if we should have a daughter, she would love to send her there. Good sound education, lots of sports, lots of science, and a finishing school. Some of the girls have ended up as the first female students at Cambridge, and some of them have even married some of the richest men in the country. Of course, not everybody approves of female schooling.
Few women are capable of higher thoughts. Medicine and caring, perhaps.
Holmes, you are old-fashioned.
All according to my experience. Look at it from my point of view. To be of any interest for me, you must be a brilliant criminal committing a complicated crime. All those brilliant criminals with really great minds I've ever met and found out were men. What does that tell you?
That they were less brilliant than you.
And that women are not brilliant enough for crime.
The fact that you have not yet encountered a female criminal does not prove anything.
I think I know every criminal in Britain. Or nearly every criminal.
I put it to you that the only truly successful criminals are those who are not discovered. How can you be sure that none of them was a woman?
Bah!
And the only criminal who ever escaped you was a woman.
She was not really a criminal.
But she was dangerous. And she tricked you. Wasn't she brilliant? Isn't she? Don't you still have her photography in your room?
Irene Adler.
Not me.
Lady Anne Worthley, I really don't know what to say. I'm absolutely annoyed, and I'm not used to being annoyed as much as this.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Do be quiet, girl. You don't know what you've done. You have not only abused the trust your parents and this school have put into you, you have not broken several of this school's rules. You left school early in the morning without allowance to do so. You traveled to London alone God knows what could have happened on the way there and at London. All this would be enough to remove you from this school. Your parents trusted you to us, to me. We are responsible for your education and your health. I just don't see how we can do it if you behave this willfully. I just